Christians can often elevate marriage, elevate sex to be this ultimate achievement in life when, you know, I've heard you, and I think it was in your recent book, Chasing Love, talk about how that's not what the Bible does or says. The Bible doesn't teach that. So for singles, how would you encourage them? Singles like myself, how would you encourage us when it comes to our view of sex and honoring God's design?
First thing is, I think as a church, we need to repent because we have made an idol out of marriage.
Come on.
We have. Pastors, writers, we have basically said, God has somebody out there for you, and your fulfillment will come from that relationship. That is not biblical. Biblically speaking, 1 Corinthians 7, Matthew 19, there are two equal ways to honor God and honor other people, singleness and marriage. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 7, in fact, Paul says, I wish you were like me and single. He seems to say singleness is better than marriage. I haven't heard that preached from a lot of pastors, to be honest with you. There's two ways to honor the Lord. They both have benefits and they both have burdens. Jesus was single. Paul was single. So we need to recover a theology of singleness. One of the things I was doing in the book that you mentioned is most sexual purity books that I've read don't even talk about singleness. So when I talk about God's design, I do sex, I talk about singleness, and then I talk about marriage to flip the narrative a little bit, because all students reading this are single anyways, mm-hmm. and singleness is beautiful and important and a good way to serve the Lord. So one encouragement I would give to you, Ben, I see this at Biola where I teach. Sometimes people are like, it's the Bridal Institute of LA. Basically every Christian college, not unique to Biola, there's this pressure to get married quickly. What happens is students miss out on enjoying and maximizing the season of singleness because they're looking past that season. And then people get married and they rush past the early season of marriage without kids to have kids. Then they have young kids. They rush past that and like, I just can't wait to have dinner without having to feed my kids. And then you rush through the seasons. We're failing to encourage people in two ways. Number one, this, if you get married someday, this is a season you have for X number of months or years. Enjoy it, flourish in it, use it for the kingdom. And if you never get married, you can find fulfillment in your relationships, loving God and loving other people as a single person.
Mm. Well, for those listening, receive that encouragement if you're single. And I received that encouragement, Sean. It's such a great reminder of God has us where he wants us in our singleness. It's not a curse. It's a blessing. We see that in all throughout the New Testament, Jesus, Apostle Paul, Amen. You haven't arrived. If you somehow, you know, one day get married, that's not, you know, the next achievement in life. God wants to use us where we're at and we can be fully content. I remember just learning at some point in my healing journey that sex is ultimately not what I do. It's who I am. I'm made in the image of God as a being with sexual desires, and I can flourish whether or not I'm married. You know, I need to not elevate marriage as some kind of ultimate thing.